Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Hello, everyone. Let's wait for a while we go for check out for more viewers. And can I see who's there? Just give me some response, give me some wave or whatever before we get to start today's session. Okay, I hope everything is all right over here. And let's see if. Key. Awesome. Hey.
Pick on my way
Hope everyone
downtown,
is
walking
well
the
and you
lines,
can hear
facing.
me. Yep, if the music is too loud, please tell me. We're gonna start our session right away. Yay. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna post a link onto your groups over there so you can actually come in through the link. I'm not sure some all of you do check your WhatsApp or not. Okay, so for your information, next week I will actually do the session separately because some of the session are actually to cater for Form fours and some of the session. Oh, not next week, maybe a few more weeks later. Because next week we are still focusing on SPM topics, okay? We are going into the SPM Physics Chapter 4 Heat Essay Question the second time. If I can find more questions for you guys to do. Alright, so if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, smash the subscribe button down there right below, and we're ready to roll, guys. Share, like, and subscribe. Share the love, boys. Okay, so today, oh, what is going on? No. I got the wrong app. Sorry, guys. I got the wrong app. Open this. PowerPoint. Right. Okay. I really don't like the blue color. I really don't like. Fantastic. Yep, this is it, and this is looking good, looking fantastic, and we're ready to roll. Okay, so let's see. Today we will start with this question, which is our question one. And in your essay question, I have already added on a little bit of files into it this week. There's a little bit of improvements. If you're using a laptop, you can see the screen pretty clearly with the questions in BM and BI together, and together with the scoring together. Yep. You might not be able to see some of the information inside because the image might be a little bit small, but later I will zoom it for you guys to see. Okay, if you guys are checking out this channel, this is the book that I am using. This is a book that I'm using. I'm sorry, guys, this is not a sponsored content. And because I'm showing you this book to acknowledge the publishers, because we have bought this book from you guys. Thanks for this book. Really nice book. Awesome. From Cepat Cetak, Sembilan Berhad, and from Yayasan Guru Malaysia Berhad. Okay. Thanks for this book. Yep, it's totally awesome. Although it's from 2014, but you know SPM questions, the style doesn't change, the concept doesn't change. The concept doesn't change. So let's rock and roll, guys. So the question number one, apakah maksud tekanan? Tekanan, go back to the basic. We go back to the basic formula. P is equal to F divided by A. Tekanan ialah daya per unit luas. Okay, why is it daya per unit luas? Because P is equal to F divided by A, daya per unit luas. Okay, So it's pretty simple over here. So I'll move. Yeah, I'll move. Okay, that is a 1 mark question. So the second, yep, we are done with this. Okay, observe both diagram. Tengok dua-dua, perhatikan kedua-dua gambar raja. Bandingkan first one, isi padu udara terperangkap, the volume. Okay, the second one, the pressure exerted. So over here, you can pretty much see everything from the top, from the picture in front. So these 5 marks, we can say you totally will score it. Not a problem at all. Then last one, suhu udara terperangkap. Okay, the last, and then after that, you need to relate. Okay, you need to relate. Relate, hubung kaitkan. Okay, isi padu udara terperangkap dengan tekanan. Okay, hubung kaitkan V dengan P, pressure. Yang dikenakan untuk membuat satu deduction. Deduce. And so, after that, you have to namakan hukum fizik tersebut. Okay, so I have already, as you can see, we have already come up with the one at the bottom there. Okay, I'm going to erase a little bit, alright. Eraser, go. I'll erase this one, I'll erase this one, I'll erase, 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 everything, okay. And let's start, okay. So, the next one is, I'll change the pen color a little bit because last week you guys said this color would be fantastic. I'll try to use yellow. Okay, if the color is not clear, please inform me because, yep, yellow. Did I say yellow? Yep, I said yellow. Yep, cool, yellow. So, first one, compare volume. Compare volume, we have to go back to the last question. Okay, you have to look back at the diagram, other diagram 1.1, other diagram 1.2, okay? Volume, so kita tahu daripada gambar aja. Please remember, it's not volume of the liquid over here. It's not volume of this liquid, okay? It's not volume of this liquid. It's not volume of this liquid. No, 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 okay? It's the volume of the trapped air. Okay, so we know that isi padu udara yang terperangkap, compare volume 1.2. Isi padu 1.2 adalah lebih daripada 1.1, okay? Let's check back a little bit. Actually, ya sudah lupa lah. Yup, correct. 1.2 is more than 1.1, okay? And then, very tricky, guys, actually, this kind of question. And then, of course, the next one, you have to compare the pressure. Comparing pressure, we know that you need to check out the gauge. Okay, kamu kena check dia punya apa benda? To that gauge lah, okay? That gauge. So then from that gauge, we notice that number 1.1 is adalah lebih tinggi. So pressure 1.1 lebih tinggi daripada 1.2. Alright, compare temperature. Temperature adalah sama. Suhu adalah sama. Now you have to relate. Hubungkaitkan isi padu udara terperangkap dengan tekanan yang dikenakan. Okay, so it's very easy. Apabila suhu meningkat, mana ada suhu? Tak suhu. Apabila isi padu meningkat, tekanan rendah. Okay. Or you can write apabila isi padu rendah, tekanan adalah tinggi. Okay, doesn't matter isi padu menurun, tekanan meningkat, or isi padu rendah, tekanan tinggi. No problem at all, okay? So the next one, physics law yang diceritakan dekat sini, sini ialah hukum Bohr. Alright, so that's it. Settle. You settle 5 marks just like that. That's it, guys. 5 marks. Essay. 5 marks. Maybe the first one here, you screw up a little bit. I don't know. Well, it's quite hard to screw up. Okay. Just remember, P is equals to F divided by A. Dia per unit luas. Okay, settle. We'll go. Next one, guys. So, explain why. Alamak, soalan ini lagi. Kita nak ulang berapa kali. Okay. Yes, you can see SPM ulang soalan jenis macam ini. Soalan pada tahun 2018 ke? Soalan 2017-18. Tak ingatlah. Okay, dia orang juga keluarkan soalan ini. So this is a very famous question if dia orang nak keluarkan Boyle's Law. So, I don't know if examiners see my video over here. Oh, budak ni dekat YouTube habak semua kalau lain kali kita keluar boys lo jangan keluar soalan ini akan toy lah korang lah. Okay, I'm sorry guys. Okay, so very easy. 4 points. First one, you have to cerita pasal kedalaman. Okay, go down. Kedalaman menurun. It's going up. The bubble is going up. The bubble is going up. So, the kedalaman turun. Okay, the second one ialah tekanan. Pressure, tekanan akan turun. Okay, so the pressure akan turun. So, kamu mesti, then you have to talk about the next thing. Tekanan adalah berkadar songsang dengan isi padu. So, if you want to write an essay, please write in words, yeah, guys. Disclaimer, I'm just writing it fast so we can do the discussion fast. Disclaimer, tekanan berkadar songsang dengan isi padu. That's why isi padu dia akan meningkat apabila gelembung itu sampai di permukaan. Okay. So, are we good? Are we alright? Pretty simple question. We're not going to talk long about it. Okay. These are the 4 points. Okay. Of course, there are a couple of more points over here. We're not going to discuss about that. Okay. Let's go. 4 points. So, wow. Those very nothing is there, okay? So, diagram 1.3 menunjukkan model satu rumah dan gambar raja ini tidak bermakna langsung. Okay? Tidak bermakna langsung. Ha? Kenapa tidak bermakna langsung? Kamu tengok gambar raja ini pun tak tahu apa dia nak cerita. Dia macam gambar raja Mego sahaja. Okay? So, let's go. The next one. Gunakan konsep fizik. Explain the use of suitable material. Okay, I need suitable material and design. Okay, to improve the ventilation. Okay, ventilation. I think I highlight better. Okay, ventilation of the house and ensure the temperature inside is not high. Temperature not high. Okay, Malay. Meningkatkan sistem peredaran udara, okay? Meningkatkan sistem peredaran udara. Reka bentuk, alright? Bahan sesuai, alright? Suhu dalam rumah tidak tinggi. That is the Malay version, okay? So the first aspect, number of windows. Let's discuss about it. Number of windows. Kalau you nak ventilation yang bagus, you nak rumah itu tak ada tingkap ke? Tak mungkin. Apa tujuan tingkap? Tingkap adalah untuk bagi udara masuk. So in the end, what's going to happen is your number of tingkap mesti tinggi ke rendah? You answer to that, okay? So size of the window. Size of the window nak kecil, nak besar. Up to you. I think you guys know the answer. Come on, okay? Specific heat capacity of the wall material. Maybe yang ni kamu rasa specific heat capacity nak tinggi ke nak rendah? Mana dia tahu tu? Okay, we're going to discuss about it a little bit. The type of material for the roof. What? I don't know. Okay, come on. We're going to do it, yeah. Okay. Additional features that can cool the house. Wah, yang ni. Cakap pasal additional features. You nak cakap. Oh, ikut suka hati kamu lah. No problem punya, okay. Tapi, dia mesti di backup oleh fakta sebab okay. Wah, hari ni saya lupa button satu. Okay. Alright, so let's go. Saya sudah start berapa minit? Saya sudah start 12 minit. Saya sudah bincang satu soalan. Okay, sudah lah. Okay, let's set the time. Mark the time. Okay, size window. I need to change the color a little bit. Okay, I'll change green color lah, ha. Huh? Okay, so essay kamu nak tulis macam mana selalunya kita akan buat dalam bentuk jadual. Why bentuk jadual? Bukannya tak boleh tulis dalam bentuk ayat. Bentuk ayat boleh tulis. Right, no problem if you guys nak. Okay, why bentuk jadual is because bentuk jadual dia menyenangkan pemerintah. Okay, cek jawapan kamu. So pemeriksa duk mak duk frustrated, dia nampak alamak saya nak baca esei yang panjang-panjang. You rasa pemeriksa macam mana? Of course dia tak nak tengok lah, right? Okay, so guys, nak please tulis dalam bentuk jawab. So pemeriksa senang tengok, pemeriksa senang hati, you senang dapat markah. Okay, let's do it. Alright, so ada beberapa benda, of course kalau you nak ada jadual, you kena ada ciri-ciri, okay? You mesti ada the second part, you mesti ada your punya sebab, okay? The reason, right? Reason, okay? And then this one is the characteristic, okay? Alright, fantastical. So, ciri-ciri first one, bilangan tingkap mesti banyak. Okay, second one. Size tingkap besar. Okay, alright. Size tingkap besar. So the next one. So the next one ialah cerita pasal, I think, muatan haba tentu. Okay. Muatan. Apa tentu bahan dinding yang tinggi. Okay? Tinggi. Why not rendah? Let's go to this later. Alright? So the ceiling, kamu pernah pergi rumah dekat kampung, kamu pernah tengok kalau kamu pergi belak tempat-tempat yang bumbung dia bumbung zing punya bumbung tengah hari panas. Okay, so we're not gonna go for the zinc, of course. So if you're not gonna go for the zinc, what are we going for? We are going for ceramic. Faham. Bumbung. Ceramic. Okay. Ceramics. Okay. Ceramics tiles. Alright. Ceramic roof tiles specifically. You can use, try not to use sophisticated language. A lot of people will tell you terracotta, la, clay, la, whatever. No, ceramic, please. You write the wrong one, you're not going to screw up. If you write terracotta or anything, get wrong, don't come in. Okay, additional feature, we'll talk about it later, okay? Because there are a couple of additional features that we can talk about. Bilangan tingkat banyak. Why? Pengaliran udara yang tinggi. Okay? Pengaliran udara yang tinggi. So these two, I would say these two has the same reason. You can write pengaliran udara tinggi. Okay? Hey, jangan tulis macam ni ya. Tulis dua kali ya. Please ya. Tulis dua kali. Don't write like this. Okay? Ini benda yang tak baik. Jangan ikut. Cause here we are focusing on speed. Okay, muatan haba tentu dinding yang tinggi. Because as all you guys know, kalau kita nak cerita pasal, you have to remember, benda yang muatan haba tentu tinggi, that means dia perlu banyak haba untuk ubah suhu. That means dia perlu banyak haba untuk panas. Dia perlu buang banyak haba untuk sejuk. Okay? So, dia nak kekalkan supaya tak panas. So, you kena guna muatan haba tentu. Bahan dinding muatan haba tentu tinggi. Okay? Supaya. How to explain this? Okay, let's go. Let's keep it simple. Supaya dia lambat supaya dinding itu lambat panas. So dinding itu lambat panas, dalam pun lambat panas. Okay. Alright. Let's check back later. Our keywords over here, are there clashing with whatever that is said in the question? If they are, probably we can consider to think whether do we need other keywords, change the keywords. If we can change, to be safe, let's change it. If we cannot change, then what to do, guys? What to do, right? Bahan din, okay, bahan bumbung. Next one, bahan bumbung. Mesti ceramic. Why? Same reason as up here, this one. Okay, same reason. So, because bahan ceramic muatan apa tentu tinggi. Okay, we good? Sing. Last one. Last one, additional feature. Additional feature boleh cakap banyak lah, okay? So, you boleh kata pasang aircon. Pasang aircon untuk menyejukkan suhu dalam, okay? Second one, bumbung tinggi. Bumbung tinggi supaya udara panas boleh naik dan keluar daripada apa, okay? Memasang, what is that called? Memasang dinding pada, memasang tingkap pada dinding yang tinggi, okay? You know some rumah dia tepi, some rumah tepi dia ada room, okay? Okay? You know some rumah up here dekat sini dia ada satu dinding. Dinding pula. Dia ada satu tingkap. Tingkap ini tujuan dia adalah untuk udara panas. You tahu udara panas kurang tumpat, dia akan naik ke atas dan akan escape daripada tingkap ini. Itu tujuan tingkap itu. Dan dia hanya sesuai untuk desain rumah yang ceiling dia tinggi. Okay? So, you can additional feature over here, you can write a few things lah. Of course, you boleh tulis pasang penghawa dingin. Fix an aircon, okay? Fix an air conditioner, alright? The second one, you can write high ceiling, okay? You can write a high ceiling. Why high ceiling? So that hot air can escape to the top, okay? Why aircon? Why air conditioner? Because untuk sejukkan rumah, okay? Sejukkan bahagian dalam rumah lah, okay? You guys write it yourself. As long as it makes sense, it makes complete sense. Have the necessary information. Habar punya topik dia begitu senang sahaja. Dia tak banyak specific things that we talk about. Once it comes to this question, this kind of essay question, okay? Except for the Muatan Harbour tentu. Alright? So that hot air can escape to the... So the hot air can escape to the top, okay? Alright? Okay, let's go. Let's continue the next question. Let's see. Everyone is okay. Everyone is okay. Ping is okay. Yo, Captain. Thank you. Memang you boleh buat kotak macam you boleh buat kotak macam tu. Lepas tu write in your ayat kat dalam. Okay. So you can write bilangan tingkap banyak. That is your ayat. Okay. That is your ayat. Bilangan tingkap banyak. Let's go back a little bit. Bilangan tingkap banyak. Your ayat nanti. Sebab supaya pengaliran udara. Okay, so then the second row you boleh tulis size tingkat besar. Sebab pengaliran udara yang supaya pengaliran. Okay. Let's go to the next question. Okay. Right. Soalan dua menunjukkan dua. Termometer apabila air dipanaskan selama 5 minit, kedua-dua pemanas rendam Ada spesifikasi yang sama. Okay, let's see ya. Okay, thermometer first one is here location. Okay, second one is lebih kurang dekat sini. Okay, lebih kurang dekat sana. Alright, so kita boleh nampak sini air sikit, sini air banyak. Okay, so, what is the question about? Let's see. First one, apakah maksud? Apa? Apa ialah sejenis tenaga? Di mana? Ya, apa ialah sejenis tenaga? Right, too long. Okay. Apa ialah sejenis tenaga? Okay. Settle. Gunakan Raja 2.1 dan 2.2. Now you see, if you notice dua soalan tadi dengan soalan ini, kedua-dua soalan ini adalah soalan bahagian B. For form 5, yeah? For form 5, soalan bahagian B. For form 4, I don't know how your format gonna go, but looks like outside the question all looks like this as well, almost like this as well. I hope it's gonna be like that, okay? Ada dua jenis soalan essay, and then it runs like that. Then you will have a smooth sailing, okay? So dia selalu ada banding A, banding diagram point one, banding diagram point two. Lepas tu dia minta kamu banding, sudah dia minta kamu buat satu diskusi perhubungan, okay? I see, okay? First one dia nak minta kamu, oops. Dia nak minta kamu buat. Okay, let's go back to the yellow pen. Bandingkan bacaan thermometer. Readings of thermometers. Volume of water. Isi padu, okay. Dengan masa pemanasan air. Okay, and then after that, Wait. Sorry, ini bukan bandingkan. This one is hubung kaitkan, okay? Relate the reading, okay? Last one is relate hubung kait, okay? Bukan banding. Hubung kait. Bacaan termometer dengan isi padu air untuk membuat deduksi berkenaan. Ah, you see this one? Hubung kait bacaan dengan isi padu, okay? Deduksi suhu jisim air. Alright? Deduction mass, temperature. Reading of thermometer, volume of water. Okay? Let's go. Let's be more careful when we do this question. Do whatever they ask you to do. Okay? First one. Compare thermometer, banding thermometer directly. Banding thermometer directly. Thermometer, bacaan thermometer. Thermometer, reading of thermometer in 2.1 is higher than 2.2. Okay? Volume of water in 2.1 is less than 2.2. Okay? Isi padu air dalam 2.1 adalah kurang daripada 2.2. Okay, masa pemanasan adalah, dia cakap tadi berapa lama? Okay? So, masa pemanasan adalah sama. Okay? Is that alright? So, relate apa binatang tadi? Relate bacaan dengan isi padu. Okay? Relate bacaan termometer dengan isi padu. Okay, apabila isi padu dia tinggi, bacaan termometer rendah. Okay. So let's then next one ask you to do a deduksi berkenaan let's go back to the question a little bit. Peningkatan suhu dan jisim air dalam cawan polistirena. Okay. Deduksi. Peningkatan suhu. Apabila jisim air dalam cawan polistirena meningkat or tinggi, okay, doesn't matter, in this case, doesn't quite matter. Peningkatan suhu adalah rendah. With one condition, spesifikasi pemanas itu adalah besar. Alright, let's go to the next one. We good. That's a little bit of changes over here, right? Good, huh? Okay, let's go to the next one. Itu saja. Itu saja. Okay. Okay. That's the next question. Okay, Raja 2.3 menunjukkan fenomena bayu laut. Explain how the phenomenon occur during daytime. Soalan ini ada kaitan dengan apa? Tengok macam tak ada. Tapi 4 markah. Point saya rasa dia boleh dapatkan lebih kurang sampai 5 points. But, how to get the 5 points, okay? But maximum mark 4 marks lah. Huh? Okay, let's go, okay? So, we will see this, okay? Tahu dua benda dulu apabila waktu siang, okay? Pada waktu siang, this one you don't need to write. This one you don't need to write, okay? So, muatan haba tentu. The first one you want to write muatan haba tentu, okay? For laut or air is more than your darat. Okay? This is the first key. Second key is that kalau muatan haba tentu laut lebih tinggi, air lebih tinggi daripada darat, waktu siang, siapa panas dulu? Darat cepat. Okay? Alright. So, kalau darat cepat panas, udara di sekeliling darat. Okay? Udara di sekeliling darat ini. Ni juga panas. Okay? Dia orang ni juga panas. Dia orang ni juga panas. So, udara di sekeliling dia, udara di darat, darat cepat panas. So, the next one, udara di darat lebih panas daripada laut. Okay? Next one. I'm not sure this one got point or other point. Okay? This one. Got point or no point, I tak tahu. QE, question mark, alright? But the next one is very important. This one confirm other point, eh? Okay, so, tekanan udara di laut lebih daripada darat. Okay, because dia sejuk, tekanan udara lebih tinggi. Because dia panas, tekanan udara. Okay? Last one. Udara bergerak dari laut yang tekanan tinggi ke darat yang tekanan rendah. Okay, so what are the key points over here? That now let's talk about key points, okay? I'll use a red pen to underline our key points over here so you can see. Watan harbor tentu laut I laut or I more than darat. This one confirm tak boleh lari. So darat cepat panas. This one can confirm cannot lari. Okay. Udara di darat lebih panas. Cannot lari one. Okay. Tekanan udara di laut adalah lebih tinggi daripada darat. This one cannot lari also. Okay. The last one maybe you can the last one you can cut down a little bit. Udara bergerak daripada kawasan tekanan tinggi ke kawasan tekanan rendah. Please, kawasan tekanan rendah. I don't have any more space to write. If I write, you cannot see. You will see my face already. I'm going to write beside my face. Okay? So, or you can actually write laut bergerak daripada laut ke darat. Okay. Daripada tekanan tinggi ke tekanan rendah. Okay. So it goes both ways. Mm-hmm.
Let's go.
Pretty easy, right? Ah. Okay. Let's go. This one. Raja 2.4 menunjukkan radiator system satu kereta, okay? So you need to do modification so that your engine ialah lebih effective, so that the engine a little bit cooler, right? The engine a little bit cooler. You need to look into the couple of aspects. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 aspects. This one tak ada benda yang boleh goreng punya sudah. Okay, this one five aspects. That's it, okay? Size of the pin use. Besar kecil, you will get the mark lah. Okay. Number of pin blade used, banyak sikit. Material, banyak sikit, mana dan banyak sikit. Material is either, we'll take a look later. Okay. Specific heat capacity of the cooling liquid, tinggi, rendah. Specific heat capacity. Boiling point of the cooling liquid. Tinggi, rendah. So here you can 50-50 lah, boleh kata. Okay, you can get 50-50 the marks lah. For the 5 marks, you can 50-50 dapat betul lah. Okay, so let's see lah. So as usual, go back to this. We have to go back to the ciri, okay? And then you have your serbo, alright? So pretty simple. Let's go. See simple size kipas. Okay, size kipas saya mesti mahu dia size kipas besar. Okay, why size kipas besar? Eh, you punya rumah kenapa nak kipas yang besar? Sejuk. Maybe sejuk, but let's be more specific. Macam mana boleh sejuk? Pengaliran udara adalah tinggi. Okay, so pengaliran udara akan tinggi. That's how you get the sejuk, alright? So the next one, okay? The next one is cerita pasal number of fin blades, okay? Bilangan sirip bilah. Bilangan sirip bilah sirip ke sirip bilah bilah sirip fin blade, okay? Bilangan bilah sirip oops. Tinggi, okay? banyak. Bilangan bilas sirip yang banyak. Okay? Why? It's because kita nak tingkatkan jumlah luas permukaan. Okay, why jumlah luas permukaan? Imagine you have a... You sekarang you kat rumah, kamu nak defrost daging. Okay. Daging ketul besar. Kamu bubur kat sana. Jok ialah untuk serap haba daripada bila sirip ialah lepas haba. Okay. So supaya suhu dia tak cepat meningkat. Alright, let's go next one. Last one. Boiling point of the cooling liquid used. Takkan didih. Tinggi. Untuk cecair penunjuk. Okay. Why? Supaya tidak tenang. Okay, just right susah untuk meruak. Okay, meruap, tersejat.
its boiling point is high so that it doesn't become vapor very quickly. Kalau dia meruap dengan cepat, kamu selalu kena tambah dia punya kulit liquid lah. That's what orang kata, tambah air, tambah air, tambah air. Why tambah air? It's because air yang meruap kat dalam, bukan cooling liquid. That's why lepas tu you think, boleh tanya ayah dalam radiator itu kena tambah air dengan apa is the cooling liquid lah. Okay, and it takes with that. So, let's go next one. Pretty simple, right? Yeah. Okay, everyone cool? Alright, let's go next one. Okay, question 3. Diagram 3.1 menunjukkan satu metal block, okay, 500 gram. Dan dia dimasukkan ke dalam air yang 200 gram dalam cawan polystyrene. Okay, 20 darjah Celsius. Apakah maksud keseimbangan terma? Okay, keseimbangan terma, this is the keyword. Net heat flow. Pengaliran apa bersih. Net heat flow is zero between two objects. Pengaliran haba adalah sifar di antara dua objek. Okay? Di antara dua bahan, dua objek. So explain in terms of thermal equilibrium, how a thermometer which is placed in the boiling, macam mana dia boleh detect 100 degrees Celsius. Memberikan bacaan 100 darjah Celsius. Okay, we need to talk about this one in 4 months, alright? Talk about this one in 4 months. Aduh, saya ada banyak benda yang tulis dekat sini. Okay, let's discuss about this question. Let's ignore this question a little while first, alright? Ignore this question a little while. So, macam mana dia boleh dimasuk? Dia masuk dan dia akan apa bacaan daripada 100. Outside is 30. Okay, so let's go. First point. Apabila termometer dimasukkan ke dalam air panas, first thing first, haba mengalir dari air panas ke berbuli termometer. Okay? Then, apa keyword? Sama equilibrium. Okay? Keyword termal equilibrium ah. Alright, tapi keyword dia tak ada dalam message. How we want to explain it, it's most important. So, suhu berbuli ataupun cecair dalam termometer. Okay, cecair ataupun you write mercury meningkat. Okay? So, apabila suhu ataupun volume isi padu meningkat. Okay, all right. At one point, okay, apabila pada 100 darjah Celsius, pemindahan haba bersih. Kali ini setting ada masalah lah. Pemindahan haba bersih. Wait. apabila sampai 100 darjah Celsius, pemindahan habar bersih adalah sama dengan ipar. Okay, so that's why your bacaan will kekal at 100 degrees Celsius. But before that, at 80-90, you bubur dalam 100, the inside itu masih 80-90 lagi. That's why dia terus kembang. Dia kembang. Okay, kembang naik, 80 kembang banyak sikit, 90 kembang banyak sikit. Okay, reach a standard 100, okay? Pemindahan habar sama, masuk termometer dengan keluar termometer pun sama, 100 degrees Celsius, that's why it stays at 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, the last point is very important, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 points, okay? Pemindahan habar bersih adalah sama dengan kosong. Alright, I'm sorry for the last one because not enough space on my note, yeah? Okay, so the next one, calculate the final temperature. Before we discuss this question, we discuss the question before that, okay? After that first. So, kita sebelum masuk B1, kita masuk B2 dan B3 dulu. Nyatakan satu andaian yang dibuat dalam aktiviti ini. Tiada habar terbebas terpersekitaran. Selalu ada andaian. Kalau dia tanya andaian, this is the andaian. Kalau dalam habar. Okay. Mengapakah polistirena digunakan daripada buka? Sebab polistirena muatan habar tentu tinggi, dia boleh perangkap habar. Okay, both points you can write. Okay, sama ada dia boleh muatan habar tentu tinggi, or dia boleh perangkap habar. Right? If it comes out in the essay question, yes, sure, right? But soalan tadi itu tak ada. Okay, so you can see 500 gram. Okay, dia panas sampai 100 degrees Celsius. Cepat-cepat dia masukkan air yang suhunya 30 darjah Celsius, okay? So, kita kena balikkan formula Q sama dengan MC Theta. Hari ini live stream macam lama sikit tapi saya sudah lebih kurang nak habis sudah. Okay, minta bersabar sikit. So, saya ada dua bahagian. Satu bahagian ialah bahagian blok besi. Satu ialah bahagian air 30 darjah Celsius. Okay, or the second bahagian ini ialah bahagian yang kehilangan habar. Okay, ini ialah bahagian yang gain habar. Gain ialah dalam bahasa gain ialah serap habar. Okay. Alright, these are the two spots over here, and I will do a little bit of erasing before we start, okay? Erase the... Erase. Okay, good. Okay. So, dekat sini saya gunakan formula Q sama dengan MC Theta. MC Theta 1 adalah sama dengan MC Theta 2. MC Theta 1, MC Theta 2. MC Theta 1, MC Theta 2. Ah, tak payah tulislah. Susah payahlah. Ha? Okay, so I have a 500 here. Alright. Tak payah convert because we want to talk about here. Here you use 500. Here you use 200. It's a ratio question, tak payah convert. C untuk blok besi ialah 800. Blok besi ialah 800. Okay. C untuk yang ni ialah 4200. Okay. The next part is the hard one. You tahu last-last kali yang ni akan daripada 100 turun pergi X. Tak tahu berapa. Yang ni you tahu daripada 30. Dia akan naik sampai X. Kedua-dua dia akan sampai the final destination, which is... Okay, so I know here is... Tak boleh mencari dekat Q.
Okay, 100 minus x. Okay, yang ni ialah x minus. Tamak, saya kena hide muka saya kejap. Okay, webcam hide. Minus 30. Okay, so x minus 30, 100 minus x. Alright, so as you can see over here, this question is pretty simple. I will solve until here. You go home and find x. Okay, why? Here is because sini ialah saya cari perbezaan suhu. Sini saya pun cari perbezaan suhu. X minus 30 perbezaan suhu. X minus 30 perbezaan suhu. Dan theta ialah perubahan suhu. Yeah. Okay. So I leave it over here and you go. You guys go finish. Okay. So next one. Raja 3.2 menunjukkan termos. Dia bagi gambar raja pada kamu, tapi gambar raja itu pun agak pointless lah, saya boleh kata. Ha? Sebab maklumat. Tapi kalau tak ada gambar raja, macam korang tak kurang nak faham sikit. Dan extra information, specific heat capacity, kaca ialah 840, specific heat capacity untuk copper ialah 387. Okay. So, which one we want to use? Let's summarize the criteria over here. Cuma ada dua jenis criteria. Satu ya, cuma ada setiap criteria cuma ada dua pilihan sahaja. Kamu sama ada nak solid ke hollow plastic. Kamu sama ada kat dalam ada vacuum ataupun udara. Okay, sama ada glass ataupun copper. Sama ada yang kilat ke yang kilat. So, of course, the first one saya, sekarang saya nak masuk, saya nak buat pilihan. Sudah saya akan tulis dekat sini, ciri-ciri. Sini saya tulis sebab. Okay. Two things saja. Ciri-ciri. Okay, first one, saya nak hollow plastik. Plastik berongga ke solid plastik? Saya nak plastik berongga. Okay, saya nak plastik berongga is because the rongga kat dalam menjadi satu insulator. Okay, dia kat dalam jadi insulator. Alright? Kat dalam jadi insulator. So, supaya apa boleh terperangkap. Okay, I will tell you this one. You guys yang apa terperangkap, memerangkap apa. Ini boleh goreng sampai macam-macam pun keluar. Okay. Boleh see ya. Sampai. Goreng 3-4 kali dalam satu esay. Yay. Okay. So let's see. The next one is saya sama ada saya nak pilih penutup. Okay. Ini ialah penutup. Alright. Saya sama ada dinding dua lapis itu. Ruang di antara dinding dua lapis itu saya nak ruang vacuum. Okay? So dia boleh merangkap haba juga. So dia nak ruang vacuum is because vacuum haba boleh terperangkap. Okay? Ataupun you can write supaya haba sukar dibebaskan, supaya haba tidak senang dibebaskan, blah 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 blah. Okay, haba tidak senang dibebaskan, haba tak senang keluar, boleh no problem to choose. Okay, dinding dua lapis kat dalam itu kamu nak apa nama? Kaca ke nak kuprum? Very easy to choose. Confirm kaca. Kat dalam ke? Okay. Kat dalam tu. You nak kaca is because kaca. Dia sudah bagi kamu tips kat bawah. Muatan haba tentu tinggi. Alright. Why tinggi? So that dia tidak senang panas, suhu lambat naik.
meningkat. Okay, tubuh lambat meningkat. Alright, the last one. So, the last one is kamu nak cakap berkilat ataupun yang gelap? Nak yang berkilat. Dicat. Berkilat. Bahagian dalam. Supaya dia boleh memantulkan habar balik ke dalam cawan itu. So, dia boleh pantulkan habar balik ke dalam dia boleh pantul habar nak keluar dia kena pantul balik, okey, dia kena pantul balik habar duk nak keluar, okey, tak dan kena pantul balik habar duk nak keluar tak dan kena pantul balik, okey. So that's how it works over here, guys. Okay. Sorry, there's a little bit of lag. Okay. Nak keluar tak dapat. Keluar kena pantul balik. Okay. So, overall, apa kriteria kita nak pilih? Holoplastic. Okay. Vacuum. Kita nak kaca, nak berkilat. Okay. So, pilihan kita adalah W. Okay. Let's see how many marks we get. Pilihan adalah W. Okay. Kerana W mempunyai plastik penutup plastik berongga, mempunyai ruang vacuum, mempunyai dinding kaca dan dicat berkilat di bahagian dalamnya. So, pointers, 1 point, 2 points, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 points, the last one. Ulang semula dia punya ciri-ciri. Okay, that's all for today. We elapsed 7 minutes from the live stream. Thank you very much for watching this episode. And hope you guys clear with how to do the essay. And next week, we have more challenging essay questions for you guys. Rock and roll. Invite your friends to come here. I'll teach you. No distribution, sorry guys. Okay, invite your friends to come here and watch. Yeah. And these are all tips for SPM technique on Java. See you guys next week.